imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky.
July 2007, a small group of people gathered together in Northeast Oregon to learn how to live our dreams and in so doing change the world for the better. What emerged from this was beyond anything we thought possible. Everyone involved was compelled to connect with and heal the land, and we had 24 hours. We explored several ideas. Building a labyrinth was one of these. It became clear that it would take everyone's contributions to accomplish. Everyone had a choice to take this on or not. The pathway to this choice was sharing with the group each individual's personal purpose in the world. From this, individual talents came together to generate a labyrinth with everyone's contribution clear and honored. This is the impact on those involved in building this labyrinth.
Pieces I recall from the labyrinth building. Early on, I couldn't see how to contribute, and in a way, I was not interested. I wasn't connected to desire personally for doing this as a community project, but I kept listening, speaking my truth from my heart. At some point, I saw that I could be part of making the first part of the path, and that I would get to ride the ATV. To learn something new and to have fun was most compelling, and I could contribute, maybe not necessarily how I thought, but I could work on the labyrinth directly. I recall being very moved by watching the elders of our community walking and seeing and making the path to the site, and then seeing and finding the site. I recall everyone being on different pages, and when we could at last see a higher purpose or calling from Spirit, the clarity and action to see next steps seemed easy, and we made very economical and swift actions. I recall, after the site was consecrated, seeing in a very visceral sense the spirit of the labyrinth grow beyond its physical boundaries. I remember not always knowing what I was supposed to be doing and being really uncomfortable. One of those times, I just held the space with others and found out later that was a real contribution. This project was multidimensional. There was the physical building of it. There were prayers. There was the experience of being at a wedding. This was a family project. This had personal meaning for the family of the landowner family. There were spirits of many times and places congregating. This was a gift for the land and for future visitors to the land. It was and is a quiet peace with great celebration.
I felt as though the labyrinth emerged out of the ground as we became more in tune with the land, ourselves, and each other. At each point, the sighting, the path, the bridge, the rope, and the time of our first walking it, it felt more about us listening and seeing. How the contours of the land could hold the form of the labyrinth, what materials were available, and who was called to step forward next. It was an experience of love, grace, and beauty within and without.
The labyrinth creation for me was an invitation to wed with my spirit, a time to honor my unique experience of life's journey, to share that with others, as we said, the generations behind and future generations. The labyrinth reminds me each day that life is a spiritual practice.
I experienced the labyrinth journey like that of a very fine symphony, a collective of virtuosos that played together to produce this exquisite tune and attunement without written music. It transformed my relationship to the unknown, myself, the land, and to each other. It has compelled me to embrace the unknown as a vital force in my life. I have fallen deeper in love with life and the possibility of living in community like this in the world.
The whole experience of building the labyrinth was one of including many perspectives on all levels. It was multi-generational. It was a blending of being real with each other, presencing dreams, and being in action. every person contributed their highest gift. There was a sense of being with the past, present, and future. The experience opened a doorway for healing for families. It healed the land. It helped a group of visionary people start to create opportunities to deliver on their dreams for the world.
Imagine if we could set aside our differences to focus on what we truly long for and desire for the world. In doing that, imagine that we could launch ourselves headlong into our dreams and start manifesting the changes we want in the world and in our own lives. This is what came from building a labyrinth in Joseph Creek.
But I'm not.